بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نويت الأربعين، نويت الاعتكاف، نويت الخلوة، نويت العزلة، نويت الرياضة، نويت السلوك لله تعالى العظيم في هذا المسجد. You are hearing? No? Put that fan off. He can raise the sound. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Higher. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Okay. Don't worry. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نويت الأربعين، نويت الاعتكاف، نويت الخلوة، نويت نويت السلوك لله تعالى العظيم في هذا المسجد. شو بدك تعمل؟ No, leave it. The sound is okay now. I didn't know. ها. هي فيها مي هيك. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. مشي حالك. الإسحاق هالمروحة اللي هون برمر هالجهة. أعوذ بالله. You are hearing? أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نويت الأربعين، نويت الاعتكاف، نويت الخلوة، نويت العزلة، نويت الرياضة، نويت السلوك لله تعالى العظيم في هذا المسجد. This is a meeting, an association of Zikrullah. Any association that you sit together for the love of Allah and love of Prophet and love of Awliyaullah is an association that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in many ahadith. ما جلس قوم يذكرون الله إلا حفتهم الملائكة وغشيتهم الرحمة وذكرهم الله في من عنده أو لله ملائكة يطوفون في الطرقات يتلمسون مذاكر مجالس الذكر. Means that there are angels. Allah created them. يطوفون في الطرقات. يطوفون is what? They incircumambulate. But before they incircumambulate, they roam. Roaming. Ignorant, they say, oh, how angels can roam? How can telephone roam? Today, you cannot hide yourself. If you have a telephone, you cannot hide yourself. That's why it's better not to carry a telephone. Then no one knows where are you. Wherever you go today, your car or your phone or yourself, and now they want to put a chip in your under your skin. To know you. To know what you are doing, where you are, with whom you are meeting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put already angels, cameras, everywhere. To check who listened to shaitan is a terrorist. He is violating Allah's rules. And anyone violating the rules of a country means a terrorist, isn't it? So anyone violate Allah's rule is a terrorist. So they don't need a definition for terrorism. Already it's given. means anyone who does not follow what Allah ordered and what Prophet ﷺ mentioned to Allah and to his Prophet, that person is following the enemy, which is Iblis, and becoming a terrorist like Iblis. من كفر مسلما فقد باء به أو فقد كفر. Whoever say to another Muslim, you are kafir, he becoming kafir. How many today they are saying to Muslims, Muslim are saying to Muslim, you are kafir. What Prophet ﷺ said? No, you, the one you said to someone Muslim who say La ilaha illallah, you say to him, you are kafir, you are the one that you are kafir. فَقَدْ بَاءَ بِهِ means يعني it will come on him. And فَقَدْ بَاءَ بِهِ means he did something unacceptable to his brother in Islam. Yani whatever sin you will, that person has will go to the one who attacked him. How many today's people are killing, Muslim are killing Muslims? Suicide bombing everywhere now in Pakistan, in Iraq, in Yemen, in many countries, in India. And who is doing it? Muslim to Muslim. As it is not allowed to do it for non-Muslim, it is moral not allowed to do it for Muslim. There are suicide bombs. There are suicide tongue bombs. There are suicide tongue bombs. Because your tongue, Prophet ﷺ said, whoever control what is between his jaws and what is between his legs, I guarantee for him paradise. And when you see something wrong, try to expose it to correct it. So when we are going to see something wrong, we are going to keep exposing it until it is corrected. Because these people are, they have tongue bombs, they have body action bombs, means through what they twist Allah's words into their own interpretations and their own imaginations, and they don't know what they are saying from beginning to end. So may Allah protect us.
Amen.
Suicide bombing is a one-time killing. And you will be punished by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and by Prophet. But suicide tongue bombing is not one-time killing. It's every moment. It's a killing, a killer. Those who are on the internet attacking others without a reason, only because they are brainwashed, they are every moment suicide tongue bombing. Means every moment are killing. It's not one killing that what happened with suicide bombing. It's every moment they are being punished and punished and punished. Like Iblis, he is punished, but he doesn't feel his punishment. He is going to feel it in the Day of Judgment. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُمْهِلْ وَلَا يُهْمِلْ. Learn your lesson. Allah delays, but he will never leave it. He delayed Iblis till Day of Judgment. Not before Day of Judgment, when everyone, when Israfil blowing the trumpet, everyone dies. But he is not he doesn't feel that punishment in dunya, but he will Allah accumulated. If he will felt it, he might repent, but he's not feeling. This is more punishment to him. Those people who claim they are something, and they keep claiming and claiming, it is a punishment for them claiming arrogance. Arrogance is kufr. Don't enter into arrogance. Keep away from it. Don't get angry. Oh, they are so angry. Because they are arrogant, stubborn. They don't loosen. Because they have no mind to think. They are stupid. So every moment they are in killing process and they are going to be punished. And that's why Allah will not forgive them in day of judgment until he, the zalim, they are zulam, they are oppressors. Until Allah take revenge for the oppressed from them, taking all their hasanat, give it to the oppressed one. And how many oppressed ones are in this dunya? Too many. And not only that, they are not trying to understand and to study and to learn the beauty of Islam, the beauty of that law that Allah sent to his beloved Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi afdalu salatu wassalam, alayka ya Sayyidi ya Rasul Allah afdalu salatu wassalam, ya Sayyidi ya Muhammad sallallahu. They have nothing. Instead of praising their Prophet, they are praising their themselves, and they are praising their that one who doesn't know how to clean himself from for wudu even. Anyone, I went to Ghana, I told you.
No, no.
I went to Ghana. No. You were there?
No.
You were there, Ishaq? And we went to that orphan school I mentioned to the Jews. And we went inside the orphan school. It was like bamboos put together and made partitioned classes like a stable where you put you cannot put your goats inside. And these people are wasting their times on the internet, sending emails and emails and emails and emails, attacking East and West. I am challenging them to tell me what are fara'id al-wudu. I went to Ghana. First class we went, young children, younger, like this one, memorizing Quran. And on the board, Alif, Ba, Ta, Sa, the alphabet. Then, second class, then third class, we came to the fourth class. And everything on their blackboard, I'm looking, all different teaching in Arabic. But according to the level of these students, until we came like certificate, fifth grade, certificate, in French is the not yet intermediary, it is finished the primary, the 5 years. I looked first, ma hum fara'id al-wudu, addit fara'id al-wudu. Count the itemize the number, the obligations of an ablution. What are the obligation within an ablution. وما هي نواقض الوضوء, and what are the that make your ablution goes, what are they? Count them. I'm challenging them and they know it. Look, go research it. And I'm challenging that Khalifa to know the Arabic alphabet. The basic. Not only him, all Khalifas, most of them. Let them tell us what are alphabet from Alif to Ya. And how many letters in Arabic? What is the first letter? Hey, what is the first letter? Alif. What you know about Alif? There is one big scholar in Middle East put 28 mujallad, 28 volumes, every volume 1,500 pages of the big size, on Alif alone. On Alif alone, 28 volumes. Not normal book size, is like this atlas. Oversized, big, this big. 1,500 pages, every volume. We have them in Lebanon. And then the war, then he, because what he did, he wrote all from beginning to end till Ya, and he sent the 28 volume to print. They printed them, and after that the war in Lebanon happened, and the rest of his work for 40 years, they burned, gone. But already these 28 were saved because they were being published. This was my uncle. Alif alone. 28 volumes only on Alif. Khulafa, ulama. You think it's so simple you call yourself Khalifa? So Alif represent what? The first letter of what? Ismul Jalala is the first letter of the word Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that encompassing the knowledge of 99 names, beautiful names. That's first letter. Means the 99 names, knowledges of the 99 names within the beautiful word Ismul Jalala Allah. And Alif is what? Is the first letter of that, the beautiful name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What knowledge in it? No one can understand. We count only we Alif Bata Sajim Ha. But we don't know the meanings. It's secrets. It's open to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What is the last name? What is the last letter? Ya. The last letter, Ya. What Ya represent? Ya represent the first letter of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam name, which is Yasin. And Allah said, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said by revelation that Yasin is Qalbul Quran, the heart of the Holy Quran. وقلب القرآن الفاتحة الشريفة. So Yasin is the heart of Quran. And Yasin, إنك لمن المرسلين. Yasin wal Quran al Hakim, إنك لمن. Allah giving an oath by Yasin and by Quran. Because Yasin is the heart of Quran, means Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the heart of Holy Quran. Allah is giving an oath by Al-Qalb al-Muhammadi. Yasin, I'm giving, Allah saying, I'm giving an oath by my beloved Prophet, Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi afdalu salatu wa salam. An oath with him, of his name. When Allah is giving oath, is not only by name, is by how much he is perfect, how much he is near. And Prophet, in every moment, he is rising, ascending, moment by moment. More nearer, zooming in, as he's zooming in, how big is coming, going deeper. As you zoom in Google today, you can see on the skies, you can go deeper and deeper, more stars opens up. Allah is saying, Yasin, wal Quran al Hakim, the Holy Quran, the wise Quran, the talking Quran, Allah's word. Innaka lamina al-mursaleen. You are a messenger. Ala siratim mustaqim. On the right path. Finish. Means anyone follows the way of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is following as-sirat. So the whole knowledge of Holy Quran and Holy Hadith and the knowledge of this universe and everyone wrote books are going to be between Alif and Ya. Can you be outside Alif and Ya? Because every word is consisting of letters between Aleph and Ya. So whole knowledges are between this Aleph and Ya. So no way means I, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah is giving an oath that I am giving an oath with my beloved Prophet Al-Qalb al-Muhammadi that you are Ya Muhammad my messenger. So everything is between the heavenly knowledge, all the alphabet enter into what? Come appearing from the Aleph, going through all the way, through all different letters, ending in the diving in the ocean of Muhammad Rasulullah. There is no other way. If we have a zarra, an atom of understanding, we can learn, then Allah open. Prophet open, awliya Allah they open. But when you are mudda'i, claiming something that does not belong to you, not everyone is a da'i. Because da'i, there is two kind of da'wah. You know them? دعوة الحق دعوة الباطل. دعوة الحق means the one who calls on the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala feeling the feeling the heat, frightened from Allah and His Prophet and Awliyaullah. And there is the other side, Dawat Iblis, the one that who is thinking himself that he is something, and Iblis is inside him. Not from his eyes entering or his mouth. No, he's entering somewhere from somewhere else. Like when Iblis and his devils came to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not coming to Prophet, but came to in the time of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, entered in the three statues, Hubal, Wallat, Wal Uzza, these three idols, the biggest, their biggest idols that they were, what?
Worshipping.
There are people today worshipping their, they think their teacher Khalifa is something. They are worshipping him, brainwashed, because of some titles, like when you say Buddha, you can see Buddha this big, and you can see Buddha size of a building. So there are Buddhas small, there are Buddhas big. Iblis, there are small Iblis, there are big Iblis. So they are happy and they are amazed with Iblis. Iblis can fly. Iblis can do miracles. Not Islamic miracles, but he can do any kind of things. He can appear to you any moment, come to you whispering. That Iblis. So they came and entered into three statues, the big ones. And they began to speak to Sahaba. And Sahaba were fascinated. The statues are speaking, they were stunned. Prophet saying to them that believe in Allah, and these statues are talking. They saying we are your Lord. This is this Khalifa, false Khalifa. They are telling that innocent people following them, we are your Lord, follow us. Allahu Akbar. May Allah bring them, these people to back to Iman. They are losing their Iman. They are worshipping a shaitan. Not shaitan, Iblis also. Not Abu Lahab, worse. Abu Lahab, every 7 days, Allah released him from hellfire for one day. On Monday, because when he heard that his brother has a son, Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi salam, he released immediately, he freed his servant Suwayba on a Monday, the day of birth of Prophet. So every Monday Allah take punishment away, because he did that action. Where you entering? Be careful. One day will slap will come on your face. If you don't know your limit, one day Allah yumhil. He is delaying Iblis. Iblis asked to be delayed. He is delayed. Allah with his wisdom is delaying. But at the end, he is throwing him in punishment. Don't want to be like Iblis. Already you went so far. Be careful, come back. Don't think Awliya Allah petting and giving you something and that you are something. We know what you are. Not you, many like you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all these knowledges, all these things that you see, books, libraries, bookstores, internet encyclopedias, internet pages, millions and millions. Yesterday they were telling me, we were visiting a company here from Maulana's Murid. He told me every day they are translating 100,000 pages from English to Bahasa language. Every day their company. Every day 100,000 pages. Imagine how millions and millions of pages, all of them between Alif and Ya, entering in the secret of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Qalb al-Muhammadi is not only for entering there what relate to heaven. No, not that only. All, every, including every breath you are breathing, it's there. Everything you are doing, it goes to the Qalb al-Muhammadi. That is the door of Holy Quran. Yasin wal Quran al-Hakim. Don't feel ashamed in front of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you do a sin, you say astaghfirullah, Allah will forgive. But if you, that is between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will forgive. Allah Ghafurun Rahim. But if you accuse a Muslim and say things that is not acceptable, humiliating someone else, you'll be punished until you go and apologize. You must not think that you are above everyone. No. You have to know that grandeur,
greatness
is when you are humiliating and humbling yourself. Oh. Not greatness when you are exalting yourself. Sayyidina al-Hussein alayhi salam, he asked when he was being surrounded by the army of Yazid. Sayyidina al-Hussein, imagine the grandson of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Ali, the son-in-law of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam described them as Ahlul Aba. If you don't know, learn. He covered them with his Aba'a. Sayyida Khadija al-Kubra, Fatimatu al-Zahra, Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu wa arda, Sayyidina al-Hasan and Sayyidina al-Husayn. Five covered them. And what he said, these are my family. Don't come. Don't teach me about, oh, he has sons-in-law. And that is the use. You are petty.
Petty.
To give such examples. You know nothing. You are speaking about an issue that happened, and it's wrong you quoted. An issue happened before they were Muslim. Not an issue happened when they are Muslim. And your quotation was half of it wrong. Sayyidina Ali is a Muslim. The first boy, young person accepted Islam. cannot give wrong examples. Behave yourself. Sayyidina al-Hussein asked for water for his younger son, Muhammad Ali Asghar. 7 months of age, he's thirsty, asking Yazid to give him water. Do you know that story? Go read. To give them water. He refused until that boy died, seven months of age. His brother Muhammad Ali Akbar, 11 years, as some seerah says, also died from thirsty, and they didn't give them water. Because they were like these peace people characters. They are Yazid of the Ummah. They are Sharisin, furious, ferocious. Anyone who is claiming something is ferocious. What Sayyidina al-Hussein answered when he saw, before they killed him, when he saw all his, the family of Prophet being killed. Yeah, family of Prophet were killed. Because you preparing a threat against us, family of Mawlana Sheikh. And you raised knives in Cyprus. You raised knives on some people in Cyprus. Don't think you are something, you are nothing. We are not afraid of you and your people. So, what Sayyidina al-Hussein said, he didn't fight with them. He said, Al-Afu عند المقدرة. What's that mean in English?
Forgive when we can.
You forgive when you can punish. You forgive when you can punish. What he answered to Yazid? He said, Yazid, you remember there is a day of judgment. And my grandfather is going to be the judge there. The shafa'a in his hand. And he with his hand will take whom he likes to paradise, whom he likes to hellfire. Allah will give him that authority. Allahu Akbar. Allahumma salli. Man dhal ladhi yashfa'u 'indahu illa bi. He is the one that gives shafa'a to Prophet. And Prophet said, shafa'ati li ahli al-kabairi min ummati. My shafa'a is for the big sinners. Means it, enter in it, the small sinners also. When you say the big, means the small goes inside. He said, when my grandfather, you are coming to him in front of him to be judged, and you are thirsty, and he at that time is able to not give you water, but he will give out of his rahmah water to you, Ya Yazid. You are killing his grandchildren, and his family, and his sons-in-law, but my grandfather is not like your character. You are a character of Yazid. We forgive, but these people, they don't know anything from forgiveness. They are Yazid way, Iblis way. Iblis doesn't like anyone to go for Shafa'a. Iblis doesn't want anyone to go to be accepted. Look, even the rain coming angry with them. Every drop is cursing them because they are cursing the Iblis character in them, not them as a body, as a honored, but their bad characters. So all the ulum entered between Aleph and Ya. Zoom in and dive, you can bring knowledge out. It will never end. Secular knowledge, Islamic and spiritual knowledge. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us.
Ameen.
May Allah bless us.
Ameen.
May Allah support us.
Ameen.
أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المستغفرين فيا فوزا للمستغفرين أستغفر الله. فاتحة. Okay, some people can go, let the drummer can sit well and let them do some drumming قصيدة. فتحنا الدفتر لنحكي ما حكينا شيء.